So I have been in a quest to figure out a way to add color. I've been really wanting to add color, and I just haven't felt the draw to get back to oil painting because I just love the charcoal and the graphite, especially the charcoal. And actually, I've pretty much moved solely to charcoal at this point. But I just, man, I have this draw to put color. You know, I feel like I'm looking at my work and it's not looking the same, but it's all just straight black and white values, you know, and I really feel like I want more and I want to experiment with more stuff. So I had this one General's single charcoal pencil. It was a red one. And I started messing with it last night. And I just really, really thought this has possibilities. The charcoal pastel does blend like a standard charcoal pencil does. So anyhow, my wife is a master pastelist and she says, I have pastel pencils. And I'm thinking, oh, okay, cool. She has a set of pastel pencils. I'm going to go check it out. She goes, you can have them. I don't use them anymore. Sweet. I'll take anything for free. So anyhow, this is what I find in our art area, you know, hid under a whole bunch of things. I had to dust it off, but check this out. Look at all these colors. And I've already taken some out because I've started playing with, which I'll show you in a little bit later. But look at all this. And it's just, and they're just beautiful pastels. Look at all these colors. All these, oh my God, just freaking me out how much beautiful color there is. And, you know, some golds and, oh, geez, I know, I'm going crazy because I love color. I draw black and white and I love charcoal, but I love color. And so anyhow, I've been really wanting to get some color into my pieces for a specific project. And I haven't been able to figure out how to do it. And the project might have to, at least this particular one might have to wait till next year, but I'm working on a new one. I don't even know if I'm working on a new one. I'm working on just adding color to some of my pieces, not all of my pieces, but just some that want color. And I've had some visitations that, you know, some visitors that they've wanted color and I haven't had a way to give it to them. So I think I might have an idea how I can. So I'm going to show and talk a little bit about what I'm doing in this video for a few and see what you guys think. Okay, ta-da! Here are two pieces that I'm playing around with those pastel pencils from Dewart. This one, you can see that I've added some color to the skin, some bluish green and some reds. And then this one I actually did go in with a gold watercolor paint. To give it just a little bit more, I don't know, you know, I just went through and I kind of did an orange back there and I didn't like it. I always liked gold and charcoal and gold and graphite. So I just went ahead and did it. And I do like the way it looks. So a little bit more of a zoom in here. You can see it a little bit better now. And, you know, for a practice piece, it came out good. You know, I think I still might finish off these little beads and stuff like that and do some more work to all this, but I might just leave it real loose. I got to fix the circle or not quite there yet, or I got to pull in the black, one of the two. But I like the gold, it's kind of fun, but I really like the color in the ear, color, you know. But it was just a practice piece, so it was fun, but I enjoyed it nonetheless. This one I'm really, really enjoying. I really like the blue that's coming through back there. I think it's really cool. So I'm gonna keep going with this one just a little bit and let you guys just see kind of the process in which I've been working. And I've been just taking a darker nub here. Actually, I've been kind of pushing off any excess graphite that might come off that I can get off. And then I've been just going in with the blue. Now I've taken this off of, because I thought this piece was done, so I've taken it off of the board. So I'm going to do my best to keep this line as much as I can. But I'm just going to kind of roll it out with a soft touch as I go out. Just to lay down a little bit of that blue pastel there. And I take my big soft brush and just pull it out. This one I think I'm going to have to get in there. Mix it in a little bit more. Where is my... I'm going to scrub it in a little bit. Just to get a little bit better of a gradient. And I'm not looking for too much color here. I don't want this to be a painting. I just want to have some color in here. You know, the pieces I've been doing, like I was kind of saying, have really just been just calling for some color work. Just a little bit of color in there. And I'm not, you know, I don't know where this is going to lead me. I really don't. But I'm excited to see where it leads, because I really, really like the way this looks. Even with that, just changing that to blue, it's just really fun. Let me zoom out a little bit. But look at the way it even helps establish. I'm going to do the same thing in this area here and a little bit here. But look how much it's helped define this cool shape, even the head. It actually is pulling that shape forward and giving me more depth. And I probably could have done this with the charcoal and the value. By lightening this up, I could just go in with a pencil. But sometimes, here's the thing, depending on the paper that you're using, and I'm using a really thick watercolor paper, has a lot of tooth. When that charcoal gets in there, it's hard to get out of those fibers. So this just gives me another way, but I love working on this because the darks are dark. And it just, but this gives me, if I have these kind of charcoal pencils, I don't have to necessarily always do a subtractive method to get to a light. I can add some color and I can pull out the shapes with that. Because you can see here, I'm running over it and not a lot of charcoal is coming off. There is some. But not enough. Not enough to help me really, really define the size. I think I'll try to sharpen this. I don't know, just go for it. Kind of gauging how far I went out down there or here, just so I can kind of get, so it looks more like a glow. See how that really, it's a nice powder. It's very much complements charcoal, these pencils. So it very much complements my style, what I like to do, how I like to do it. Just really kind of pull it out, soften it up. It's cool, very cool. So now I'm gonna go in, this is kind of my mid-tone that I'm using, this nice green. Look at how that just nicely blended in. I'm gonna go with the lightest green that I have in here. I'm actually gonna do a little bit of that. Slight touch, but look how much already that's creating, that is pulled out and pushed forward, that shape. I definitely could go in more with this lighter color here. Look at that. Isn't that just really a cool, just a really cool look? And I'm going to come in here with some of my charcoal pencils now, and I'm going to solidify some of these shapes here. Some of the hair that I had coming down. I turn that around, and is that neat? I feel like I could even still go in there and lighten that up. Use the lighter colors just a little bit more, which means I might have to go back in there and redefine those shapes, those little hair fall that I have coming down there. So there you go. I'm not going to finish the whole thing, but I think you can see how this could really add to my work in specific cases. Not every piece am I going to do something like this, but I feel like I've just added to my arsenal, if you will, to my skill set. And I still need to experiment and push this farther and farther and farther. And I wonder what would happen if I pushed it farther and farther. You know, I could see eventually maybe even taking this where the whole background is the color and the character is just the charcoal. It would be really a cool and interesting look, you know. But for this guy, I think I'm gonna do down here, you know, between his legs down here, make blue, some of this blue, and I'll probably do a little bit back here, maybe a teeny bit, you know. But it really makes, I feel like it makes the piece. And let me know what you guys think, but I really feel like it takes the piece to a whole new level of fine art, of character. So anyhow, thanks for following. Tell your friends to follow me if they're not. And I'm going to do some more of these color pieces and see what you guys think. And I'll talk to you soon. Thanks. Bye.